it. So I'm glad you're all passionate about being here because we are passionate to have you here. So I am privileged and honored. My name is Amy Lance, by the way. I'm the Director of Business Advising and Student Services. So I have what I call the best job on campus because I get to work with each and every one of you.
Yeah.
Okay, so I also have the privilege to introduce to you your college dean, Dr. Julie Inman.
I am so happy to see all of you. Welcome to Chico, welcome to the College of Business, and we can see that everybody in this room has already made excellent choices. Excellent choice to go to college. It is associated with so many great outcomes in life, including, of course, we all think right off the bat, more income, but actually things even more basic than that. Actually, it's even associated with better health, better relationships, better family life, all kinds of things. Education is just a cornerstone, really, in so many ways for living a good life. So we are so glad you chose. And we're so glad you chose to come here. Chico State is an awesome university. We are the only campus in California who met all of the criteria set by the federal government for being a campus that is a good value, a good bargain for you, a place where you are likely to graduate in an efficient way, a place where you are likely to have actually wonderful career outcomes, a place where you're not going to get head over heels with debt. So we're so glad you decided to come to Chico State. It was a great choice. And we cannot say enough about how thrilled we are to have you in the College of Business. We are the portal to the world of work. You know, Freud once said, adult life, two big things, love and work. In other words, finding a way to show your love to everyone you encounter and finding a way to use your talents, use your strengths to contribute to something larger than yourself. That's really what work is. And so we are all about teaching you the knowledge, the skills, giving you experience to apply it, giving you tons of ways to make new friends, to build your social capital. I'm in touch with a number of people from when I was an undergrad. And so this is such a fabulous time of your life. We're just so very, very glad to have you here. And so today, we're taking a little time out with you as a group to try and show you the five most important things. You know, we know where you're getting, you know, tons of information. And so we want to boil it down for you to the most essential things. What are the things you need to know right off the bat to start off on the right foot? And so Amy is going to take you through a few of those.
Okay, and I will tell you, I believe you've made one of the finest choices by not only choosing the College of Business, but Chico State, because something you're going to learn very quickly here is most of us are alum of this fine institution. It's such a fantastic place that we never want to leave. So I've earned all my degrees here, and I've been teaching in the College of Business or in business doing advising for over 16 years now. So you are going to have a tremendous time while you're here. So we encourage you to really outside peer advisors are outside, because after this, we have a huge connection fair for you. So, if any of you are still having issues with registration, guess what? My team all has their iPads on them. We can work while we're at the connection fair, enjoying some bagels and live music and festivities out there. So, look for anyone on my team, and they are more than willing to assist you. Or if you have questions about your fall schedule, let's talk about it now. Also, besides just talking to you about classes, there's a lot of things that we're supposed to do with you, and we want to make sure that you're doing things in a timely fashion. So we as a team, a few years ago, created what we call a college roadmap. And so this is so that you know, you're a freshman, you're not only what classes should you be taking, but, you know, how can you expand your horizons? How can you connect with your peers? How can you think globally? And then how can you start preparing for life after college and graduation? And so that's for every single step of the way for you. Okay, number four, get out of your comfort zone. And I think this is something that's really hard for everybody, not just college students, but this is your chance to be who you really want to be the person that you were put on this earth to be, and to try things you may have never tried before. So I can't encourage you enough to get out of your comfort zone. And if you need help doing that, you come and see my team, and we will help you with different opportunities. One of the things that we have done, and this is brand new, effective for fall 13, our office is also responsible for student success. And so we are launching for the first time a number of programs to help you get connected and be successful. So our first event is on September 4th, and that's a classroom etiquette event. So those of you that are first-time freshmen, I'm going to give you one of the things that is going to come up in this presentation, which is do not raise your hand in class and ask if you can go to the bathroom. You don't ask anymore. You go. No one needs to know, not your teacher, not your classmates. But I always forget when I'm teaching freshmen, someone always raises their hand. So there are things, there are differences about being in high school and being in a college classroom. There are differences about being at a community college and being at a four-year institution. So my team is prepared to help prepare you for classroom etiquette. This is all on the flyers that we passed out to you. On September 6th, we're going to do a student services scavenger hunt. There are more resources than you could imagine on this campus. If you have any issue, any problem, anything you need, there are services for free on this campus for you. So we're going to do a scavenger hunt to make sure you get connected with each other and your campus and the services. Then on September 26th, it's Self-Improvement September, so we've partnered with the Wellness Center, and we want to make sure that you're not only doing successful in the classroom, but we want to make sure you're successful mentally, physically, emotionally. So we're going to talk about that. October 2nd, you may not think you need this because you were an A student in high school or at the community college, but I assure you, this is a big difference in college. And so on October 2nd, we would love to help you learn the twists and turns of avoiding academic probation, and we partnered with our general advising office to do that. Then on November 4th, we have a resume building workshop, because 2 days later, we have our very first career fair on the campus, or actually it's our second career fair. So you will be prepared to go and start looking for jobs. And I know some freshmen might be thinking, lady, I just got here. I know. I want you to go to the career fair now, because you need to start looking and planning for those corporations and those businesses that you are interested in working with, and you need to hear firsthand from them what is important. So say Chevron's there, and you say, my dream is to work for Chevron. Ask the recruiters, what are you looking for on my resume? What is going to make me stand out? Let the employers tell you. Make connections with them right now so that every year you go to the career fair and you reconnect with them, and then by the time you're a senior, they're already waiting for you. They are holding a spot for you to interview. Okay, and then November 12th through the 15th, the College of Business has more international students than any other major on campus, and they come here and they learn about all of us and our, you know, culture shock they have, and they learn about our differences and our traditions, but we often don't take the time to get to know them. So we are going to do the week before Thanksgiving international traditions, and every single day of that week, we are going to get to learn a different culture's tradition. And then December 2nd through the 6th, by then you're going to be stressed out because you're going into finals and crunch time is on. So we're going to do distress fest, and we will have something every single day, every single week of that day, and that all of our events include food. Yeah, usually all the students are hungry. And if you're not now, it's because you're just coming from home, but college students are usually hungry. So we will have food at all of these, and the College of Business Advising, you'll learn real quickly, is into health and wellness, and so a lot of your snacks will be healthy, feed your mind, feed your brain with good food and energy. Okay, number three is become a master time manager. This is the number one skill that all, especially our freshmen, need to learn, but our transfer students as well. Time management, you're on your own. Nobody's coming to your room and waking you up and getting you to class. Nobody's even going to make sure you come to class, and very few faculty will even check if you're in class. It's all on you now. And so you need to become a good time manager. You need to learn to successfully balance your time between studying, between being in the classroom. Many of you will need to work. Some of you will volunteer. And I'm guessing most of you will have social life. Well, that all takes, that's quite the balancing act. And even us as professionals can tell you that is extremely difficult. So you need to learn to be a good time manager. And if you need help with that, there are workshops that are put on by the Student Learning Center for free to help you learn techniques to be a good time manager. Trust me, we all have the same amount of hours in the day. It's about how we manage them. Okay, and number two is also extremely important and one of the hardest things for all humans to do, and that's to ask for help. So there's a lot of people here to support you. In a little bit, we're going to release you to your faculty, your student leaders, your fellow classmates. There are lots of people that are here to help support you, but you might have to ask us for help. So I can tell you, number one, you are welcome to walk into Business Advising Glen 321 anytime and say, I'm just lost. I don't know what I'm doing, and my team will be prepared to help you. I also cannot encourage you enough to make strong connections with your faculty. The faculty at this institution came to Chico State and work at Chico State because they love Chico State. They love the life that this awesome community provides, and we are one of the last true college campuses. It will not be uncommon for you to see me at the grocery store. Janelle and I would be in my kayaks, you know, tubing the river. I'm not kidding you. I ride my bike to work every single day. I will be riding right next to you as you skateboard in or ride your bike in. Your faculty are the same way. We'll see you downtown at Trace Ombre's for dinner. We'll see you at Farmer's Market. We will see you at all of the community events. This is your community. This is our community. And this may seem like the biggest town you've ever been in, but we're all connected. And soon you will get to see that. You will never be able to go anywhere in the world without running into other people connected to Chico State. Trust me, I left the country to go on vacation to get away from everyone. And there I was in the pool, and right next to me, Chico State students from my class. You don't get to go anywhere now. You are a part of the Chico State family, which truly is a blessing. So please do not be afraid to ask for help. If you need assistance in classes, I'm proud to tell you the College of Business has now launched its own tutoring program. Glen 206 is our Student Success Center, and you are welcome to come in there Monday through Thursday from 7 in the morning until 9 o'clock at night to do your homework, hang out, collaborate on class projects, but we also have tutoring for some of our more challenging classes, Accounting 201, Accounting 202, Finance 307, and Batting 300. We also have Batting 101 mentors who have office hours within that room. This is your space. This is the first time the college has ever done that, and we are super proud. So use the space. If you are struggling in other classes within the College of Business, come and talk to me. The more you tell me, the better the chances I can get tutors for those classes. And now I will turn it over to Dr. Inman.
Well, we're into the home stretch here. We're almost ready to launch out to our festivities. But number one, and already you've made some great choices, as I said. You're in college, you're at Chico State, you're in the College of Business, but there are some more choices you need to make. Day by day. Actually, that's what adult life is. Adult life is day after day of choices. Do you make wise choices for yourself? Do you take good care of yourself? Do you meet your responsibilities? Do you give yourself the chance to be the most you can be? Or do you sleep in and miss classes? Do you drink too much consistently, affecting your health, affecting your ability to study and remember what you're learning? Do you get involved? Do you join student organizations and meet friends with similar interests and be able to develop leadership skills? Or do you just hang back and, as Amy said, stay in your comfort zone? So making good choices is really at the core of this, and I urge you, I really urge you, because you all have so much to offer. You have so much to offer life, you have so much to offer this campus. And so I urge you to make good choices. And so I would say that Nelson Mandela said it very well for us. May your choices reflect your hopes and not your fears. You might know that this campus has had the tragedy of several students who died by binge drinking. And so I want to put it right out there. I don't want it to be the elephant in the living room that we all know is there and we're not talking about it. No, we need to talk about it, because what did that reflect? Well, it reflected some young people who didn't take themselves seriously enough, who didn't realize how valuable they were. And so I just urge you, take your talent, take your strength, take what you can bring to the picnic more seriously than that. Take good care of yourself. Stay healthy, stay safe, stay wise. And so once again, we are so thrilled to have you here. Welcome. Welcome.
We have a table for every single option.